Alright, so when it comes to mid-range Android phones, there are a ton of great options for buyers with different needs and wants, but in the case of the Pixel 6a, there's just a unique way that it stands out from the rest. I've been using the 6a for a bit of time now, and for this one, let's see how well it's held up. When looking at the Pixel 6a, it's important to view it in the context of price and hardware limitations. It's not meant to compete with phones like the Galaxy S22 or the S23 or even the iPhone 14. Instead, it goes after other wallet-friendly Android phones like ones from Nokia and Motorola. Now, the Pixel 6a pretty much represents how much Pixel features you can get for not much cash, and while it's not perfect, I'd like to think that it's managed to break some boundaries when it comes to cheap smartphones. Now, we do have some earlier content here on TeamVRY that focuses on the Pixel 6a, so feel free to check those out. With that said, let's get to the video. Let's start off with software. As far as mid-range Android phones go, the Pixel 6a manages to provide a polished approach to Android in terms of software. For one, it already has the latest Android 13 update, whereas other budget Android phones are still launching with Android 12 even in 2023, despite it being somewhat old now. In the 6 months that I've owned it, the 6a also has received monthly updates. This ensures that any bugs are addressed quickly, and you also get some of the latest Pixel features. In terms of stability, Android 13 on the Pixel 6a has been a more refined experience as well. It's pretty much better than the buggy mess that we got on the Pixel 6 with Android 12. I've gotten none of the connectivity and performance issues with Android 13 on the 6a, and it's pretty much been stable overall, especially in day-to-day usage. Now, speaking of day-to-day usage, it's another aspect where the Pixel 6a shines versus other Android phones. While most mid-range and budget phones out there come with underpowered Snapdragon and MediaTek chipsets, the 6a comes with the Tensor chip, Google's first-party flagship SoC, and it can hold its own when it comes to both modern use and even gaming sessions. Switching between apps, video and music streaming, browsing the web and social media are all easily handled by the Tensor chip. You get a very clean Android interface thanks to Google's focus on keeping Android clean with a reasonable level of customization, just so much that things don't get too boring in terms of visuals. Now, as for gaming, the 6a will be able to run most games on the Play Store, and games like Call of Duty Mobile and League of Legends Wild Rift will be playable without lags and frame drops. With that said, however, more graphics-intensive games like Genshin Impact will really push the 6a, and you'll most likely experience some heating and occasional lag on the phone. But then again, we have to go back to the price tag when taking factors like these into consideration. For a lot of moderate smartphone users, though, the Pixel 6a will be more than enough for general use, and if you really must compare benchmark scores, it outperforms most mid-range chips out there. Now, this wouldn't be a complete Pixel video if we didn't discuss the camera. Camera performance on the Pixel 6a has remained pretty consistent since the day I first got it, and if you're a long-time Pixel user, maybe you've used the older Google phones, then you'll be familiar with how the 6a handles image processing. As someone who pretty much uses the Pixel 6a for point-and-shoot scenarios, I have to say that it's been a satisfying journey so far. Now, I'm not a professional photographer, so I won't go into the specifics of what makes a great and balanced picture, but for the type of scenarios that I use the Pixel 6a for, like social media posts and YouTube content, it's pretty much on point. Photos aren't too saturated, exposure isn't blown out, and there's just enough detail so pictures mostly look solid. Now, if there's one weakness to the camera, I'd have to say that it's video. There's only so much that you can do with 12 megapixels on the main camera, and comparing the quality of the Pixel 6a videos side by side to something like the Pixel 7, you can really see the shortcomings of the more affordable Google phone. But as far as still photography goes, the 6a manages to get a lot of things right. Now, with all that being said, I do have a few issues with the phone. For one, it does tend to heat up with constant data and camera use, something that I've noticed when using the phone outdoors to take photos while connected to the internet. Gaming does result in some heating as well, which you'll want to take into consideration. Another thing to take note of is that the Pixel 6a does lack features like cinematic video and the spatial audio feature. Although on one hand, it's kind of understandable given the older Tensor chipset, and Google does have to cut on some corners to differentiate the 6a from the more premium Pixel phones. Another point of concern for some users might be the build quality, since the Pixel 6a comes with a plastic build. Now, this is not an issue in itself, but the kind of plastic that Google has used here is pretty much glossy all over. As a result, it's a lot more prone to scratches, so I really recommend using a case with a phone. I do use some protection designed by Spigen for the 6a, which you can check out here on the channel. Alright, so in closing, I do think that for a mid-range smartphone, the Pixel 6a manages to get a lot of things right. It's got reliable performance, a great camera, And it goes a lot cheaper now given the discounts from third-party retailers and occasional price drops from Google as well. If you're looking for a no-nonsense budget phone, then you can't go wrong with the 6A. There are compromises in terms of hardware, and we do miss out on a few software features, but all in all, it's a nice way to get into the Google Pixel experience for not much cash. Alright guys, so do let me know your thoughts on the Pixel 6a. Have you been using it for long, or have you upgraded to a more high-end phone? And yeah, let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.